我现在来到荷兰的 Hermit， 这边有世界第一座 3D 列印印制出来的混凝土桥。这座桥呢，花了3个月的时间打造，是自行车专用的桥。这座桥启用之后，不仅让当地的居民生活便利，更使得 3D 列印技术在建筑层面上有了新的里程碑。今天我请到了一位专家，我就来问问看，这座桥到底安不安全？位于荷兰东南部的海默特尔 Hemert 小镇，在2017年委托恩和芬理工科技大学设计长约8公尺的混凝土桥。这座看似简单的桥，技术上可没有那么容易哦。来听听这项计划的研究教授 Theo 是怎么说的呢
？Is it safe?
It is safe. You can, you, yes, for sure. Otherwise, I would not stand here with you. Of course, you travel that far not to stand on an unsafe bridge, I guess. No, it's really safe. We did a lot of work. So first of all, we tested the concrete, the printed concrete. Then we made a 1:2 scale model, half of the size of this one, and we tested it fully in our laboratory at the university. And then finally, when this bridge was finished and before it was open to public, we loaded it with just a huge amount of water. We stacked water up to this high to see if it was strong enough.
Wow. And
then we know, okay, now we can open it for public. This is the first time you make a full bridge out of a printer, and you must make it safe. So yes. We wanted to keep it simple, make a small bridge with a safe bridge, and show the people that we really made it in a very safe manner. That was really, really important for me.
Yes.
听了 Theo 教授的解说，这座桥可是经过了层层试验才启用的，所以保证安全啦。但这座桥看起来与一般的桥没什么不同，不知道这座桥是独立打印出来的，还是印成套件再组装呢
？So we printed a series of elements. So it's not one bridge because the bridge was not printed like this. The bridge was printed like that.
Oh, it's printed like.
Yeah, and we couldn't print it that high.The printer is big, but not that big. So we printed elements. As you can see here, we have an element over here that starts here and there. So you must think about this element here that was flipped like that and then printed completely. And then when we placed it, we flipped it over again. So this is one element. That's another element. Third element, fourth, fifth, and the sixth element. So they were printed like that and then placed like that.
So it's not print out the whole bridge in the same time, so break down in pieces.
We could have printed it in one go, but it's 7 meters, and our print box is 5 meters high, so that's impossible. So we could print it in 2 parts of 3.5 meters. That's what we could have done. But the problem is, it's so heavy, how to take it out? In our laboratory, you don't have the equipment to do.But theoretically, yes, we could print it in one go. But just for practical reasons, we printed it in 6 elements here.
Theo 教授说，外表平淡无奇的 3D 桥，可是暗藏许多机关的呢。想要更认识这座 3D 列印桥，就要从不同的角度来看哦。
What you see, the bridge is it's a hollow bridge. So it's not a massive element. This is not fully concrete. It's hollow in it.
It's hollow.
Yeah. So if you can see, we printed a nice curved shape.And the inside is hollow. So it's just a hollow element. And that's the good thing about 3D printing, because if you pour concrete, it would have been massive. Yes, very heavy, very massive, all a lot of concrete. And now it is just a little bit of concrete, much less. So it's hollow in the middle. So actually what we did is because it is hollow, we had an iron bar that is going through the bridge from the beginning.Completely to this end, and then you pull at that end, and I pull at this end. So both of us are pulling, and then we blocked it at both sides, and then that bar was just stressing the concrete like a series of books. If you want to pick up by 2 hands 10 books, you press the books, and then you can lift them. That's what we did with this bridge. That's how we constructed this bridge, and for that reason, it's a straight bridge.
That's why.
Yes.
从 Theo 教授认真又充满热情的眼神中，让我感受到这不只是一座让自行车通行的桥，更是研究团队的心血结晶。接下来 Theo 教授要带我们去他们的研究室，哇哦，是不是可以看到超大型的 3D 列印机呢？跟着教授去一探究竟吧。
So this is the biggest 3D printer in the world?
It's one of the biggest 3D printers in the world. I don't know if it's the biggest one, but it's one of the biggest.
But it is really very big one.
It is. Yeah, it's actually, you know, all the small 3D printers, the desktop printers. It's exactly the same one. Yeah, the desktop ones. But what we will do now is, we increase the size of the printer or we shrink you, because you can stand now inside the printer for the first time in your life, I guess.
So I see the 3D printer, we saw these and the computer. So can you explain to us how the 3D printer works?
Oh, I will. Let's start with the beginning. And we have to make concrete first. Mm-hmm. Shall we do that?
Okay, so where to?
It starts here. So let's, please join me. What happens here is this is one of the mixing machines. Mm-hmm. We have a series of them. What happens is we start with a dry mix, which simply means cement and sand.
And sand.
And this. As you can just touch it. It's just cement and sand. You make dirty hands.
Because, is that normal with the traditional concrete?
No. There's one. It is with one exception. Uh-huh. There's no aggregates inside. So the big aggregates, the stones, are not there. It's only if you sense, it's only fine sand that you will touch. 1 millimeter,
the
2 millimeter.
Is big stones.
Yes, the big stones. So normally you make concrete out of cement. Mm-hmm. That's the lime. That's what connects everything. Then you have the sand particles, and then you have the aggregates, the grains, that's the bigger parts, up to 2 or 3 centimeters. These big parts are not here. Mm-hmm. So we already have cement and sand, no big stones inside. That's what we don't do. And I'll explain you later why.
要认识 3D 列印机前，先认识最基本的材料，研究室所使用的混凝土跟一般认知的不同，这是专为 3D 列印机使用的混凝土，它像沙一样的细，里头看不到实粒，不会造成管线阻塞。接着透过帮浦再将混凝土经由管线带到列印机上，接下来就交给机器人来操作咯。
So the machine actually comes, the printer, the robot, the gantry robot, this is called the gantry robot. Yeah, that comes from the packing industry. It's meant to pick up something at one place and then bring it to another place and put it down.
Yeah.
So this was an existing machine. And then the pump,come from the plastering industry. So in-house, if you have a gypsum wall, they plaster with a shotgun and bring the plastering material to the wall for a nice surface finishing. So that's where that machine comes from. We use it to make our pumpable and printable concrete. Yeah.
利用 3D 列印机印制出的混凝土，硬化过程需要3个小时。机器在列印的同时，混凝土还是液态，那不就四处流动吗？这要怎么固定成型呢？
The first 3 hours I'm printing, the bottom layers, you can still take them out. It's just mud, wet material. But it is shape stable. For that reason, it is there. But if you put your finger in it, you put your finger through. That has no strength at all. After 3 hours of printing, the material starts to harden. And all of a sudden, you feel that you cannot grab it out anymore. And then,after this is finished, this print only takes an hour.
So if only this takes print, an hour.
This takes an hour.
Wow.
Yeah. And if this is finished, you can just by the hand take the concrete out wherever you want. You can just put your hands through. Don't try now because it's hard.
It's hard.
You can do. And then after the hour, what we do is we gently cure it, which means we put plastic foil on it, because we don't want the moisture to get out. The concrete needs the moisture to harden. And that's really important.Then 2 hours later, that's 3 hours after the start of the print, you go and you will sense it becomes hard. Then you have to wait. The morning after, it feels like this. But it's still not strong. You have to wait for 4 weeks for the material to reach its final strength.
什么啊？要等待4周，将近1个月的时间，混凝土才能定型完成。这样怎么可能在3个月内建好这座桥呢？Leo 教授，你该不会有什么秘密武器吧？
So what we do is we can accelerate this process. So instead of 3 hours of setting time, 3 hours before it starts to become hard, you can shorten that period and make the concrete harden within an hour or half an hour or even 10 minutes if you want.
With.
Yeah, you add something. You add a very mystery material to make it harden faster. Yeah, and in general, these type of materials is just salt. That's the idea. If you put sugar in concrete,
it will never harden.
You mean salt? We eat this,
yes,
this salt.
Yes, I mean the real salt. If you put salt in concrete, it really hardens fast. Yeah. If you put sugar in concrete, it will never get hard at all.
哇，我真的是大开眼界！眼前的机器不单单只是桌上型的 3D 猎鹰机放大版而已，根本就是一个可以完成人类天马行空想象的神奇工具。这个新工具将来还会带给建筑界什么惊喜呢？
Now to start with, it gives us a lot of opportunities to have free-form shapes, and we're not limited to rectangular shapes anymore because the printer can go in any direction we want. So the freedom of shapes, I think that's the first issue. The next, what we will see, is that we have a more freedom in the texture of our surfaces. If you pour concrete in a mold, it's always a flat surface. Otherwise, you have to work hard to make a very special mold. And now, what you will see, we can make a lot of texture in our surfaces. So that's from an architectural point of view, I think, one of the biggest advantages of 3D concrete printing.
在阿姆斯特丹70%的交通工具就是自行车，而荷兰也是一个与水共居的国家，所以渡船也是他们稀松平常的交通工具。今天就搭着渡船来见识一下 3D 列印打造的房子到底长得是什么样子。
哇，这就是用 3D 列印印制出来的房子吗？好特别的形状哦。Hi.
Hi.
I'm Wesley.
I'm Hans. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Welcome.
So this is a 3D printed house.
Yes, this is 3D printed.
So what do you think the advantage of using 3D printing construction?
The advantage of printing is that you can make tailor-made architecture for mass industrial prices.
You can customize that. Is that you can customize things, but in affordable prices? Is that what you mean?
Yeah. So you use industrial robots.
Mm-hmm.
So you can really go into perfect fit, made to measure building solutions for a very good price, and with that you cut down on waste.Production, because there's a lot of waste being produced on the building sites.
Yes.
Almost like 25% of all materials going to a building site, they're not going into the building, they're going into the waste cycle.
Wow.
And that we think should go to zero. And that's possible with printing, because how we print, it's an additive manufacturing. Mm-hmm. So you only put the material
you want
yeah. and you need, so you canbe way more smart in the usage of materials.
这个精巧的小屋，除了建造时降低了废弃物以外 ，Hans 说，建材本身也是利用植物提炼出来的塑料，是一种可再生资料。另外，小屋的外形设计也藏着设计者的小巧思哦。
That's a typical house.
Yes.
So everybody understands it's a house,、mm-hmm. right? And then with this kind of.Diamond shape. Facade. That's the idea that these parts can be used as solar panels.
Oh.
So then you can imagine that when you buy a plot in Taiwan, that、mm-hmm. you can move the digital file moves this to your perfect solar angle.
原来这个钻石般的外观还有这样的环保功能啊，真是个聪明的设计。除了小屋 ，Hans 的公司也将 3D 列印技术广泛应用到如楼梯、墙壁、地砖等建物。不过，我又发现了一个特别又有趣的东西。
So, these tables are amazing. What are those?
It's a table we made for a loft in Tokyo. It's a、uh-huh. It's a department store.
Yeah.
For their new flagship store in Ginza.And we created a special landscape、uh-huh. table, let's say, where we used,inspired by the Japanese folding techniques.
Folding techniques?
So it's like they do it with paper.
Paper, oh.
And we translated the paper folding to、mm-hmm. 3D printing. And with that created kind of a
It looks like a mountain.
It's like a mountain.
Like island.
Yeah, it's like a mountain. Yeah. Like Japan is an island, mm-hmm. right? So it kind of refers to the country, both on hand craftsmanship, mm-hmm. context. But then it's like beautiful as a landscape,
yeah.
but it's also functional.
一个简单的设计就能让一张桌子不但有美感，还兼具实用的功能。3D 列印技术在建筑上的运用又再次让我惊艳。3D 列印的技术推陈出新，在荷兰我们看到了印制出来的小屋，在大陆的苏州已经印制出可让人居住的房屋，无论中式庭园或西式洋房都可以客制化打造哦。
哇，我今天就是来这边找 3D 列印的建筑耶，这个果然就是我熟悉的这个 3D 建筑的样子。
对啊，哇，
哎，这边一进来啊，然后就是有一种洋式的风格，哎。
对啊，虽然我们这个用的是传统的建筑，园林建筑，但是呢，我们所谓所有的室内装饰都是一个中式的风格。当然，我们看到这个屋顶上，顶上这个还是木结构，这也是我们用 3D 打印方式，现代的建造方式跟传统的，建筑方式一次结合的尝试。但是上面这些望砖你可以看到都是我们打印出来的，包括这些墙面。
哎，我看到这个桌子，哎，它应该也是 3D 列印出来的吧？啊，
宝宝很聪明，确实是，它真的是 3D 打印出来的，是不是很漂亮？跟里面的材质又不一样。
对，哎，对耶。
这个呢是它是我们整个是一体打印出来的。
哦，它是一体打印出来的。
对对 对, 对，当然这个材料跟刚才的那个。主体的结构材料不一样了，之前那个是所有的是混凝土了，这个是我们的研发材料叫 FRP 的一款材料。
FRP
对对对，它很轻，但是它的强度很高。嗯，对，可以做一些室内的家居浴缸。
哎，朱公，我看到啊，就是像就是这样子，就是所谓用 3D 列印印出来的这个墙面，它都是这样子一层一层堆叠上去的嘛。
对的。对的。
那其实怎么讲，就是说现在很多人其实他们其实也蛮喜欢这种。墙壁裸露的风格嘛，
对我们然后当然了，如果说你不喜欢这种，也可以我们再进行表面再进行另外的装饰，比如说刮平抹平，这个都可以随心的选择。对，哦，
所以就如果我要刮平抹平，其实对结构上是没有影响，
没有影响，没有任何影响。哦，对对对，如果你要抹平，就像看一看这样的我们的这个仿古的窗花，它表面就是平的了。
哦，所以这个也是 3D 列印印出来的。
对对 对, 对，
以往的窗花制作都需要制模、灌模，现在只要印制出来就行了。在这中式庭院中，我感受到一股质朴的美感。这些美感的呈现，除了 3D 列印机的帮忙，还是需要人类的巧妙设计。
所以说，像这样的，比如说我们看这样的一个绿化种植段，这就是一个设计师的一个巧思了。对，它机器它不知道有这样的功能，但是你人可以赋予它这样的功能。可以这样的设计，更为巧妙精准的设计。对对，
哎，我看到了这个，这就是你说的刚才那个滴灌的那个水管嘛，对不
对？
对
呀，啊，对呀，啊，它这样的滴灌回收，包括它这样的水下来以后，我们都有进行回收。哦，可以回收回去循环利用，这样就不会再浪费。
来到这个园区，就像是刘姥姥逛大观园一样，处处是宝，处处是惊奇。像是我眼前这栋白色建筑，主体为曲面。扶手采用 FRP 材质，薄而强硬，充满设计感。看着这些厚厚的柱子及墙面，我很好奇里面有什么结构呢？
这个呢，就是我们说把一些现有的一些白色的垃圾、白色颗粒垃圾回收回来，经过我们的处理，混合我们砂浆填充进去，当做一种内墙的保温。这个是成本又低又便宜。
这个东西看起来是很像那种你买那种大家电，然后
对对对，
外面的那个白色的像保丽龙的东西是吗？
对，就是那种东西，就是家电的包装泡沫，我们进行了粉碎处理，进行我们的处理，然后再填充进去，作为一种保温材料来使用。对，
所以其实很多时候，你的眼中的垃圾。
对对，
是垃圾。
对，只不过它是放错地方的宝贝。
墙及支柱内部，除了保温层材料是回收再利用，支撑主体的部分也是有玄机的哦。
这就是我们一些在大楼当中有一些结构柱啊，你看，我们就整个是打印出来这种模壳，然后把钢筋啊这样的东西放置进去。然后整个进行浇筑起灌注起来，它是结构柱，结构柱的话，它还是要有这种有设计标号的混凝土以及它的钢筋放置在里面的。嗯，对。
所以就是说如果是一个大楼的支撑的柱子的话，它还是需要比较这样子比较强化的结构。
对对对，就是
做加强，
从现有的设计的这种结构体系里面还是需要有这种东西的。
在墙面内发现，如果不是建物受力处，不需要整个灌泥，可利用弯曲的设计节省建材的浪费，也利用这样的空隙来做一些管线的配置，真是一举数得。
其实我常常看到就是 3D 列印的建筑或东西的时候，我都会想到它们其实很像就是那种自然的生物，它们自己筑巢的时候的方式。
对啊，
就像蜜蜂，它就会就是你知道采一些东西，然后也是像泥状的分泌物，然后最后它们筑成了一个巢。
对啊，
或者是像燕子一样，就是它们会就是雕一些东西，然后最后把它们叠成自己的巢。所以我看到这些东西的时候，我都有一种似曾相识的感觉。
是的，是的，那种呢，就是最天然的、最原始的 3D 打印方式了。嗯，实际上那只不过现在我们人类模仿他们的行为，用科技的手段
是
来实现这种 3D 打印。比如说呢，冠豪，你可以猜一下，你看这是什么？
这个，这个看起来太大，不像椅子啊，因为但它应该不是椅子，
是不是造型很复杂？
对，
是吧？其实我们是考虑到，我们现在人类对自然的索取太多了，而且破坏造成的破坏太大。嗯，我们 3D 打印啊，我们想给自己人类打印房子，那我们其实也是想能不能给一些小动物、给自然界的一些小生物打印房子呢？哦，对，
所以这个是
我们给海洋的小生物、小鱼、小虾、珊瑚礁打印的一些小居所。哦，对。
哦，就是把它丢进海里，然后他们会让它创造一个像是珊瑚礁的生态。
对对对，就是仿生的一个形态。你看到我们可以看到里面很多这种曲面的制作的形态。
对，
这就是我们扫描一些岩石的一些形状，然后把它那个打印出来，就是创造一个小鱼小虾的这种小那个生态环境，把它们再回应过来。嗯，这样的，对。嗯，所以说我们在科技发展同时，不能忘了这种环保自然的东西。
除了一些给海洋生物居住的地方，也可以利用 3D 列印打造植物生长的环境。科技发展与自然资源如何达到一个平衡，是人类在追求进步的同时需要思考的。在园区内，我还发现到一栋五层楼的 3D 列印建筑，朱工说那是他们的员工宿舍。要将 3D 列印打造的房子推向一般民众，已经是指日可待了。
建筑的工法日新月异，从传统的方式一路到现在的 3D 列印技术。 3D 列印技术呢，除了省时省钱之外呢，也可以减少在生产过程中所产生的粉尘以及空气污染。更重要的是，人都喜欢天马行空的想象，所以 3D 列印技术的加入使得建筑的方式有了更多的选择。